Hey there, everyone. It's Jim from George's topic this week, which I'll read and answer in a minute. But first of all, I wanted to say to Jim and Brent and Lucy fans around the world, I'm so sorry. I loved Lucy. I always looked for her. There was something about her that, something about her personality that I connected with. And so it was, I realized it was a long distance internet relationship. But I loved her very much. And I'm also an old dog owner. And I dread the day. Mr. Cosmo's here with me at the moment. And so, yeah, just my heart's with you. Big love to you guys. And that was a beautiful tribute to her at the end of your video. It captured her most Lucy moments. So it's just so sad. But yeah, I'm so pleased that you were brave enough to make the right decision, though. I don't even want to think about what I have to do when it gets to that, but I'm just so pleased that you guys managed to do that, and I'm thinking of you. Anyway, the topic this week is, I'm going to read it. Katy Perry recently spoke of how she learned that her religious upbringing, which had taught her to fear gay people, was completely wrong. She said, "These people were nothing like I'd been taught to fear. They were the most free, strong, kind, and inclusive people." So when was it that you first realized that being LGBT was okay and that you were not all alone? When did you finally discover that there were millions of ordinary folks out in the world like you who just happened to be LGBT? I really liked the statement from Katy Perry, especially from her perspective. I don't actually have this perspective. I wasn't brought up in a religious household. There's two things that I always think about when we come somewhere on the fringes of this subject, and one is that even though I wasn't brought up in a religious household, I've been fortunate to be around a lot of different religions and people who hold a lot of different beliefs. And I have yet to come across any religion or any spiritual journey where it says to those people who hold that faith, go out there and live a lie. You know, I haven't come across a religion that says that. And the second thing that I have noticed from seeing such a broad range of religions is every religion in the world at some point has been hijacked. And this is why it's really important for people of those faiths not to question their faith. No, not at all. But to question, has their religion been hijacked at some point? Is this about spirituality? Is it this about divinity? Is this about a god? Or is this about a crazy human? Is what I'm saying. Because even if you look at the very fundamentals of things, if you look, for example, at what different religions have said, monotheistic religions have said about people being transgender. And then if you look at God as an entity, do you think if your religion believes in an all-knowing, all-seeing, all-encompassing creator who transcends divinity to such an extent that it's beyond human comprehension, do you really think that's a white man? Or do you think, I mean, I don't know, but to me it would be far more logical that such a being, such an entity, such a god, whatever you want to call it, would be agender, would be well beyond gender and race and body and sexuality and all of those things. To me, they would transcend all of those things. And yet, it's almost like, let's hijack that and just portray God as man. Because, hey, that's convenient, right? Like, so I notice all these things that impact on the LGBT community. And I kind of sometimes think there's no reason that people can't be LGBT and also have their faith. I don't have a faith. I have no capacity for religion whatsoever. But I feel like so many of the issues that we come across every time when we, as I said, when we touch on these things, the issues are with humans. The issues are not with the religions or the spiritual path or the spiritual journey or any of that stuff. When did I realize? I didn't have a single moment in time where I realized that I was not alone and that there were LGBT plus people everywhere. I think to some degree I was always aware they were everywhere. I did have certain moments in time where I realised people thought, hey, that other people thought this is not okay. I never held that belief internally. I'm certainly guilty of sitting in silence while other people said it was not okay. But I never actually thought it. And I think those times probably stand out more to me than the times, because it seems like there's always been LGBT people around. Even when I was a child, there was LGBT people around. I went to underground clubs very occasionally, I should say, because this is extreme risk-taking behaviour that I don't suggest anyone does, in the Middle East. But I was young and stupid. And there's absolutely nothing wrong with going to LGBT clubs there, but the consequences are too high. You know, you can be imprisoned, or in some cases you can end up with the death penalty, and the consequences are far-reaching for your family, for everything. It's complete madness. I certainly don't advocate anyone doing it. However, when you go there, to those places, they are packed to capacity. It is wall-to-wall people. You cannot fit in the place. Even with the consequences being as they are, and nothing kind of screams born this way more than that, because that is so not a lifestyle choice. That is no choice. And that certainly made me realize there's thousands of us, because there were thousands of people in those clubs, and that was the people that had the courage and the bravery that day to happen to go there, that certainly I knew didn't represent everyone. I don't think I ever thought that we were alone. I mean, we've always been here. We've been here forever throughout history. So I'm sorry, it doesn't really answer the topic. It's all a bit roundabout. But I still liked the way Katy Perry said that, because she didn't have to say it. I think it's probably the real reason that somehow I have some affinity to it. Anyway, I'm going to get out of here. Take care. Leave your comments below. And I'll talk to you soon. Bye for now.